Hello fellow model makers, and welcome to the third edition of our Tamiya 148 scale F-16 CJ Block 50 build. Right, so the build is coming along nicely and it's time now to finish a couple of minor sub-assemblies. The central landing gear is already glued in place and now I put together the forward landing gear. The front wheel has these two very distinct ejection marks that need to be filled and cleaned. Actually, despite its impressive engineering, this kit is full of ejection marks. Initially, I did fill many of them, but then I realized if I filled all of them, I would be working on this kit for a couple of months. So, I am now just filling the more visible ones, like these. I am using perfect plastic putty. Once it was dry, I scraped away all the extra putty and then smoothened the area with a Q-tip dipped in water. I now put together the ejection seat and all remaining cockpit parts. The landing gear is now painted white. Now to hand paint the wheel. The ejection seat and cockpit parts are now painted. there are a few decals that go in the wheel well and the cockpit. The instructions are not very clear about the positioning of a couple of the decals, so I did a quick check. Now I glue in place the nose. Two things here. Firstly, do not forget to add some weight in the nose, even though the instructions do not indicate that you need to. The kit may not be a tail sitter, but still, never hurts to add a little weight just to be sure. Also, I glued in place what I believe is the air data probe, the needle on the nose, which I should not have done. There is a high possibility that I will snap this while doing the build. So I eventually had to cut it and then glue it back when the build was much closer to completion. Okay, time to paint the pilot. Now I usually do not use the pilot figure, but in this case, the cockpit I felt was not detailed enough, especially given the F-16's big clear canopy. The ejection seat is now glued in. And in goes the pilot. The pilot's arms are glued in last, just before he's placed in the cockpit so that one can move them to the appropriate place on the controls. A little aluminium dry brushing is done. Time to clean up this horrible seam on the canopy. I start by gently scraping away with my hobby knife. We'll be right back. Next, some sanding with the 1000 grit sanding sponge. Now, some further sanding with a 1500 grit sanding sponge. To restore the shine on the canopy, I use Tamiya's polishing compounds. I keep polishing the canopy till I'm satisfied with the finish. The final touch is a rub with Tamiya's modeling wax. Time to mask the canopy, which I did with this ultra-thin masking tape and then filling the inside with masking fluid. This was a rather easy masking job given the design of the canopy. Now to mask the wheel wells, which were rather more difficult to mask as compared to the canopy. Finally, we can get on with the paint job. I start by giving the kit a black base. I now feel that perhaps Tamiya's gloss black or even AK Interactive's extreme metal black base would have been a better choice for a more shinier finish. Ah well, you live and you learn. Now some white paint to marble the base. What I did not record was that between each layer of base paint or reshading, I sanded the kit with a 1500 grit sanding sponge, very lightly, just to make sure that I get an even smooth finish. Now back to the black to do some panel line pre-shading. Right then, fellow model makers, the pre-shading on the kit is done and we are ready to start applying the final colors. But that will have to wait till the next part of the series. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please do like and subscribe. Till next time, good luck and happy modeling.